Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please turn your attention to the center ring. Straight from his home in Bulgaria, you will see, somewhat new to the area, suffering from bouts of delirium, come and join in the hysteria for Boris the Dancing Bear. Taken by a strong gust of wind, Boris begins to dance, accompanied by his friend Sasha the lion on fiddle. And his gypsy band. Boris swings to the left and to the right. He shakes his bulky legs and spins around and around. Swirls faster and faster. Until he falls to the ground in utter exhaustion. The crowd erupts with laughter. All the while, Boris sits embarrassed and alone under the spotlight in the center ring. The boisterous noise is interrupted by the booming roar of, no, not Boris the Bear, or Sasha the Lion, but a man, a cruel and heartless but simple man, the circus head animal tamer who calls himself the Master. Master enters the ring. Boris pleads and backs away from him. But it is of no use. The master grips his paws and slaps chains on his wrists. There will be no supper for you tonight, Boris, says the master as he leads him away. Later that night, the sounds of melancholic music can be heard emanating from the cage of Sasha the Lion. Thank you. next door, Boris weeps softly. I will never dance again, Boris says. Certainly you don't mean that, replies Sasha. Oh, I certainly do. And you know what else? Anger wells up deep inside Boris. He has never been angry before, and it scares him a little. But it is too late. His anger causes his body to shake, and he raises his arms up above his head. Grits his teeth and flexes his muscles. And he breaks free from his chains. I'm leaving the circus for good. Then no one can make me dance, and no one will ever laugh at me again, Boris says. But Boris, Sasha protests, you don't know what you will find out there in the world. Unknown things lurk in every corner. Scary things, no doubt, says Sasha. Boris puffs out his chest. I am bigger and scarier than most things in the circus. Surely it is the same out there in the world. Sasha knows it is pointless to argue with his friend. Then I will come with you. You just may need my help. It isn't very long before Boris and Sasha have left everything they once knew behind and reached the outskirts of a vast and entirely unfamiliar desert. Where is the green grass? Why are my feet sinking? Asked Boris. Why, this is sand. I remember it from my days as a cub when I was free, Sasha answered. The two friends forge ahead timidly. What was that? Move on, clutching each other closely. In the distance, a shadowy creature appears. She approaches, scuttling from side to side, scaling the sand dunes. Boris and Sasha freeze in fear, for there is nowhere to hide. Soon, they are face to face with... I am Ludmilla, the scorpion, and look what I can do. Ludmilla begins her enticing dance, tapping her feet, clicking her claws, and swinging her stinger. As her grand finale, Ludmilla balances on the tips of her claws and brings her stinger down. Swoosh! into the sand, right in front of Boris's toes. Boris yelps!
What's the matter? You don't like dancing? Lumilla asks.
I've never seen a dance like that before. And no, I don't like dancing. You can't make me dance, Boris says with a humph.
Just tell me where you're going, and I'll let you on your way, replies Ludmilla.
We are running away from the circus, answers Sasha.
Ludmilla, thinking this sounds like an exciting adventure, decides to join their caravan.
Many hours later, it is twilight in the desert. A frightful sandstorm moves in overhead. Wishing to avoid getting overtaken by the sand, they search for the nearest shelter. Look! A grand cathedral! They scramble up the massive stone steps, past the gargoyles, and toward the heavy wooden door. As Boris reaches for the handle, the door creaks open. They tiptoe inside the darkness. Is anybody there? Boris's voice echoes through the hall. Lightning flashes, filling the darkness and illuminating colorful stained glass windows.
What do you want? Says a deep, slow voice.
Lightning flashes again, and in the glare they see beady eyes, pointy ears, and fangs. They run for the door, but it is still locked. They pound until their fists and claws are raw.
I see that you've noticed. I am a vampire. Call me Victor.
He raises his arms, spreading his black cape.
I can smell your blood, and I could eat you. But I'm not hungry.
It is only a matter of time before you become hungry, so if you would please let us go, Boris says.
Into the storm? No.
Stay and listen.
I would prefer the company.
Victor sits at the dusty harpsichord. He blows on the keyboard, releasing a cloud into the air. Music lures them closer and closer. Sasha, as if unable to help himself, takes out his fiddle and draws his bow.
It is more fun to play with other people, no? Where are you going? If you promise to play music with me, I will come with you, says Victor.
As far as the circus, as our legs will take us, I will listen to your music, but I will not dance, Boris reminds everyone.
Okay, that is fair, says Victor.
Boris and his caravan reach town. It is bright and sunny. Even he cannot help smiling. But soon they encounter a crowd of children and parents gathered around something in the town square. It is a puppet show. The puppeteer whirls his raggedy puppets to and fro, making them dance to the puppeteer's music box. Boris begins to whimper and cowers behind his new friends.
Whatever is the matter?
Asks Victor.
They are only people. They will not hurt you.
But they might laugh at me, exclaims Boris.
Pah, says Victor.
Don't worry, says Ludmilla.
It's okay. We don't have to stay, says Sasha. But as they turn to go, who is it they see emerging from the crowd? None other than the master. Seeing his escaped animals, he runs toward them. He signals to the people around them, "Stop them!" Boris growls, Sasha roars, Ludmilla waves her tail, and Victor flashes his fangs. Some people in the crowd run away. Others stay frozen in place. But nobody wants to cross a bear, a lion, a scorpion, and a vampire, except... the master. As he approaches to grab Boris by the arm, Sasha steps in the way, giving Ludmilla the chance to sting him with her stinger. The master yelps in pain. All it takes is one last hiss from Victor, and the master turns and runs away.
Now we are truly free, says Boris, embracing Sasha.
Puppet show begins again. The puppeteer calls to them. Please, join me. I could use some colorful characters in my show.
Thank you.
Masha plays the melody on the fiddle. Ludmilla adds some percussion. Victor takes his place at the piano. And Boris? Well, Boris begins to dance.